Hey y'all, welcome to another WordPress Wednesday. My name is Corey Ashton here in San Antonio, Texas at WebTegrity, and you have found a YouTube channel solely dedicated to all things WordPress. So if you are interested in figuring out how to use these Google fonts inside of your WordPress website without using a plugin, that's what I'm going to walk you through right now. And of course, if you watch my channel, you know I recommend that you use no more than a dozen plugins, 12 plugins at one time. You start to see your website kind of bogged down if you use more than that. We actually recommend here at WebTegrity to use 5 or less if you can get away with it. And this is one of the ways you can do it. It's a little bit more intimidating, kind of, because you have to learn a little bit of nerd code or dive into a few files that might seem a little scary, but don't worry about that. Follow me. I'll walk you through it. So of course you're going to go over to fonts.google.com, right? And you're going to check that out. Go here. I'm going to go ahead and maybe pick out 2 fonts that are pretty different looking from each other so that you can really see the difference on my example site. I'm going to grab Ravi and Railway here, both of those. And you can see as I'm adding them by clicking the little plus sign, they're adding them down here for me. Now, when I open up this drawer, y'all, check this out. Super, super easy. All we're going to do is copy this one section here. That's this link file. I'm going to copy that onto my clipboard. And notice that they've included Railway and Ravi. Both of them are sitting here for me to use. So I've got both of those on my clipboard now. The first step is to jump into your dashboard. You're going to go to Appearance and go to Editor. And the first place you're going to look for is a file called header.php. We're going to click on that and open that up. Now, before you start tinkering in here, please know that we can break our website if we're in here and we accidentally mess something up. So I need you to be very, very meticulous while we're working on this. Be sure to set down the beer, set down the wine. Be sure you have a backup in place, all right? Absolutely know how to roll back your website if something goes wonky or weird here, okay? Anytime you're in any of these little files over here, be aware of having of a game plan of how to roll back your site, okay? So what I want you to do, no matter what theme you're using, I'm using one called Olsen Light, doesn't matter. Your theme up here is going to have a file or a line in here that is /head. You're going to have one that's without the /. I want you to find the one that has the /head. That ends our header. Well, we want to go just before that. Put your cursor there, and I want you to paste in that really cool little bit of nerd code right there. That we got from Google Fonts, right? We want to paste that in right there, and then I want you to scroll down and click Update File. So what this does right now is it allows us to reference the cloud where those fonts live. That's step one. There's only 2 steps to this. It's pretty straightforward. Now we just have to tell our WordPress site, where do I want to apply those 2 different fonts? What sections of my website do I want to change? Well, what we want to do is use a theme that allows us to have a custom CSS box inside of it. Most of the themes these days offer that. So we're going to go into that area next. Let's go do it. Most of them live inside of Customize, or perhaps they're inside of your theme itself. Our particular theme, it's inside of Customize. I'm going to scroll down here, and this one says Additional CSS. So once you see the front side of my website, there's a little bit of paragraph text that lives here, and then this is my H1. So I know I want to affect those. So let's write a little bit of nerd code, okay? Inside of our CSS, our custom CSS box, I'm going to say P for all my paragraph text. And then open curly bracket, close curly bracket. And inside there, this is the nerd code you paste. Check this out. You don't even have to write it. You can just copy and paste it. I want to use Railway for my paragraph text. So I'm going to copy font family Railway, just this bottom line here, because that's the only one I want to use for my paragraphs. Did you see that magic happen just then? Look at that, you guys. Hold on. I'm going to undo that. Look at what font is here. It looks like that. And as soon as I paste that in, look how cool it changes. Immediately it applies Railway. So let's say now that I want to change and use Ravi for my H1. So I'm just going to type H1, open curly bracket, in curly bracket, and kind of scoot over there a little bit and organize some things. And I'm going to come over here and go get Ravi. And now I'm going to jump back into my file here, paste that in, and look at that. Look up here. There's my fun font happening up there. Isn't that cool? So this one must not be an H1. Let's see what this little guy is right here, our home option there. If he's not an H1, he's an H2. So yeah, it's a little H2 sitting there. So we can actually just add that to it and say all H2s as well. And there you go. Now our little guy here lives as H2 in Ravi font. Okay, so hold on a second. Y'all are probably saying, wow, you talk way too fast, Corey. All that flew by me. Just click pause for a second. Rewind me. Click pause. This is pretty straightforward. The only tricky part is trying to figure out what your author named each section that you want to manipulate, right? Because I didn't know that home was not an H1. Home is actually an H2. So in order to find those things out, you can use your inspect element, right mouse click and say inspect element, and it will show you what your author coded that section to be, and you can apply it inside of this custom CSS box. Isn't that cool? All right, if you have questions about this, first step, take a look at my other YouTube videos because I've got quite a bit on learning CSS so you can do stuff like this. Super cool, way nerdy. Next step, put it in the thread below. Let's talk about it. Ask me some questions. Give me a call, send a tweet, connect with me. I would love to help you. All you have to do to make this thing go live is, of course, save and publish up here. And then it's all going to be applied to your website. And this style sheet right here cannot be overridden inside of any updates that you do. Isn't that super cool? Hey, I hope you're having a great WordPress Wednesday, and I will see you all next week. Bye, y'all.